to It's a Lovely Day with Lovely Waters. It is a new day. But in spite of the evils of this present world, God is faithful. You know, David said in Psalm 34, I will bless the Lord at all times. His praises shall continually be in my mouth. May God bless each of you in Jesus' name. And you guys, come on. Spend a little time with me in the Word of God, where we will see examples of God's love, see examples of His peace, see examples of His goodness, see examples of God's faithfulness. Jesus Christ, our Lord and Savior. May God bless you again in Jesus' name. Come on. Hello, this is Lovely Waters again. As I always say, I'm excited about what God is doing. Amen. I want to thank each of you that have come to be a part of our program today, tonight, whatever hour that you find yourself with us. We want to say welcome, and we want to praise God. I praise God for you, and I trust that God will bless each of you, amen, with a blessing that you will not leave without having received what God has to say to you. All right, I'd like to begin, as usual, with our opening scripture. Our opening scripture is coming from John, the 12th chapter. John 12, and that begins with John 12 and 23. And it's going through 33, okay? And if you'd like to read along with us, I'd love to have you join us. All right. John 12, 23 through 33. And it goes, and Jesus answered them, saying, the hour is come that the Son of Man shall be glorified. Verily, verily, I say unto you, except the corn of wheat fall into the ground and die, it abideth alone, but if it die, it bringeth forth much fruit. He that loveth his life shall lose it, and he that hateth his life in this world shall keep it unto life eternal. If a man serves me, let him follow me. And where I am, there shall he also be my servant. If any man serves me, him will my Father honor. Now is my soul troubled, and what shall I say? Father, save me from this hour. But for this cause came I unto this hour. Father, I glorify thy name. Then came a voice from heaven saying, I have both glorified it and will glorify it again. The people therefore that stood by and heard it said that it thundered, and others said an angel spoke to him. Jesus answered and said, this voice cometh not because of me, but for your sakes. Now is the judgment of this world. Now shall the prince of the world be cast out. And if I be lifted up from the earth, will draw all men unto me. This he said, signifying what death that he should die. Amen. Praise God. And those scriptures came from John 12, 23 through 33. Our message today for our word today came, first of all, from John 12, 23 through 33. And our lesson or message is entitled The Eternal Choice. Okay, I also want to, you know, stick in a little bit of alabaster news. Today is the day that Jesus, our precious Savior and Lord, was crucified. We cherish this day that symbolizes his sacrificial suffering. Jesus was crucified at a place known as Skull, also known as Calvary. He was flogged and nailed to an old cross by his feet and wrists. He was tried and he was convicted of violating Jewish law, which said he was blaspheming. Darkness covered the land from 12 noon to 3 p.m. Today is known as Good Friday. Even though it represents a day of mourning and sorrow, the death of Christ Jesus on the cross was truly the ultimate sacrifice for the sins of the whole world. That's our alabaster news. I also want you to know, as you most of you know, that there's Good Friday, the day of the crucifixion. And then, according to the prophecy of Christ, the third day he would rise. And there's Saturday. And then there's Sunday, which is the day that he rose from the dead. Amen. Therein, today is a good day because it represents the crucifixion of our Lord and Savior, Jesus Christ. I want to thank each of you for being here once again. And I want you all to know that it is my prayer, and I've already told God, that it is my desire, my hope, and my prayer that no one will ever come to the alabaster box and not receive a blessing from the Lord. So I advise you, open up your heart. Amen. Allow God to speak to your heart and bless you. Amen. Because God has a word for you. Amen. Moving right along, I want to say that in all of this that we've talked about in terms of the 3 days that Christ was on the cross, yet he rose on the third, therein it was a Good Friday that we celebrate today again. I'd like to also go forward and say that God wants us to get a true significance of what it means, amen, what the cross means, and what Christ was, what his message and his purpose and his sacrifice was all about. It was all about the eternal choice. Jesus gave us a choice to live, and he also let us know that we had a choice to choose death. But if we choose Christ, then we have life. And we have life more abundantly. John 12 and 33 says, amen. We have a choice. Amen. And I don't know about you, but I choose life. I choose Jesus Christ. Because he told us, if I be lifted up, he said, I would draw all men, women, boys and girls, and all the people of this world, Jews and Gentiles, amen, unto me. God came for all mankind. He loves each and every one of us, regardless of our race, regardless of our culture, regardless of our creed. God loves us, and he loved on us through Jesus Christ, giving his life for us on the cross. Praise God. Jesus gave us an eternal choice. The eternal choice is only one: to live with God eternally, to work out our soul salvation in fear and trembling, or to live eternally in hell. So let us move on here. I'm not going to beat around the bush. I'm going to tell you what thus saith the Lord, because I know, amen, that when I don't teach or preach the way the Spirit of God tell me, your blood could very well be on my hands. And I'm not going to allow anybody's blood be on my hands because I didn't tell it the way God said it. So I want us to know that in 12 and 32, Jesus again was saying that when he is lifted up from the earth, he was talking about on the cross. Amen. He would draw all men, women, boys, and girls, all people of the world unto him. That was his goal. That was his desire, which was to please his Father, was to be obedient to what he had promised his Father that he would do. It was a love, praise God, for his Father, and also a love for all mankind. Jesus loves you. Amen. That's why he came. That's why he bled. That's why he died. That's why he rose, so that you would have a right to the eternal choice, which was the tree of life. Amen. Praise God. Through Christ Jesus. The term lifted up refers to the crucifixion. The word of God compels us to humble ourselves before the Lord. And then he will lift us up. Also, James 4 and 10 tells us that same thing. Humble yourselves in the sight of the Lord, and he shall lift you up. What it really kind of says to us, that we must go down before we can come up. Amen. So as we move on here, we see that, I hope that we are prayerfully beginning to see the vision. And I know so many people have been told, you know, Jesus came and he died for our sins and he was on the cross for three days. Wait a minute. I'm not going to teach it like that, even though I'm saying the same thing. But I want to say it in a way where it can sink in, where we can truly examine it, where we can truly receive it, where we can truly get spiritual understanding that Jesus came so that we might have life. And that there's no life outside of Jesus Christ for me or for you. Jesus made the difference between eternal life and eternal death. Eternal death, meaning burning forever and ever and ever and ever in hell. Fire. eternal damnation. John 3:14-15. Let us go there. John 3:14-15 says, as Moses lifted up the serpent in the wilderness, even so must the Son of Man be lifted up. Now here we have a situation coming out of Numbers, the 21st chapter, where the children of Israel were belly aching. They was complaining. They was saying, well, here you are, Moses, did you really bring us out of Egypt into the wilderness to die? They were not satisfied. They had seen all the wonders and the miracles that God had done. But yet they began to talk against God. They began to talk against Moses. They began to talk about against the holy things of God. And God, he allowed serpents to come and begin to bite them. And as they began to bite them, many began to fall and die. But then they began to quickly turn to Moses and said, Moses, we are sorry. Forgive us for speaking against God and the things of God. He said, please ask God to come and save us. Moses did just that. He went to God and he asked him to intervene and come and save the people. Amen. And it's like that sometimes. Sometimes God allows us to see that we went too far wrong. And if we are willing to go down, all right, if we're willing to humble ourselves and cry out to God, then God will in earnest. We got to be earnest. We got to be sincere. He will, because he's a merciful God. He's a good, he's a loving, he's a kind. He's a trustworthy, and he's a loyal God and Father. And he did just that. He said, Moses, I want you to take, amen. First of all, I want you to know that there is a parallel between Christ being lifted up on a cross and Moses putting a serpent of brass up on a pole and lifting it up for the healing of the children of Israel. God sent a solution to the healing of the people and they lived. But this was the requirement. Those that were willing to humble themselves, repent, and look up at the serpent, they were the ones that were healed. God is telling us, do this season, reminding us, amen, as we have come through this Lent season, to continue to remember that we must first come down. We must first humble and cry out within earnest. And look up, amen, and trust God, believe, and God will heal us, amen. Resurrection day, amen. A day that he was lifted up, a day that he rose up, should I say. God, the God of Abraham, Isaac, Jacob, of the Old Testament. He rose up, amen, and Jesus went back, amen, to his Father. Amen. Just as he had said that he would do. And this is a part of trusting God's word. For each and every one of us, it's a challenge, but yet this is our mandate. That we must believe and trust God that he will do what he has promised us to do. This is God's way. And these, all these things are what we are required to do, to live as, praise God, people of God. Resurrection Day is a day wherein Jesus gave us an eternal choice. He gave us an eternal choice between life everlasting and eternal death. When our time comes to leave this place, we're going to go one or two places at the appointed time, in God's appointed time. We're going to either go when God calls us forth and judges us. We're going to either go and live with him in peace. He's going to welcome us in to the kingdom of heaven. Or he's going to rebuke us and send us down into the pit for all eternity. So we need to think about that. I'm talking about all of us. Leaders, teachers, preachers, bishops, mothers, evangelists, missionaries, lay people, the President of the United States, the Army, the Air Force, the Marines, school-age children, those who have understanding of who God is. Amen. So God wants us, amen, to remember that there is a day that is coming. And it is a day when there will be a great reckoning. A day of reckoning is coming for each of us. So God wants us to know. He wants us to prepare. Amen. We must be born again. We must be born again to receive eternal life. That means we must believe in Jesus. We must believe in Jesus. Amen. Who he was, who he is, and who he wants us to be. In him. That's the only way we can be like him. Is to follow his example, is to follow and trust and believe in his word. We must be born again. And once one is born again, we must not fail to trust in God for our daily life paths. That means that we must be dependent upon God on a daily basis. Amen. On a daily basis, hourly basis, we must call on him. Lord, lead me, direct me. If we're in a situation that we are not comfortable, Lord, he's always there. He's as close as the skin on our faces. Lord, how do I approach this situation? What do I say? How do I say it? Lord, help me to live a life that is filled with more good than bad. This is what Jesus did for us. He gave us life, and life more abundantly. God gave us the eternal choice through his son, Jesus Christ. You can't help but love him because he's faithful, even to right now. So let us face God and fall down face first before him. Serve him, worship him, repent of our sins, and receive him through Jesus Christ, our Lord. This is Lovely Waters with the Alabaster Box. I want you to come back and be blessed in Jesus' name. Hello again. This is Lovely Waters. And I hope that you all receive something from the Word of God. And as I always say, He tells us in Isaiah that His Word would not return to Him void. So as it went out, so did His will and His purpose. I'm doing a new thing because God said He would, and I also want you to know that at the end of each video, I want to compel you to think about the word that has just been given and know that Jesus truly is an answer for every problem, every situation, every trial that you may be going through in your life. That Jesus cares and that He's real. Oh, yes, He is. He's real. And He wants you to experience new life. So I want to lead you to Christ. And I'd like to begin with an invitation to salvation. No matter where you are, how low, how discouraged, how depressed, how oppressed, how it may, you may be at your wit's end, how you may not even want to live much longer, God can deliver. So I want to begin with Romans 10:9-10, that if thou shalt confess with your mouth the Lord Jesus and believe in your heart that God hath raised Him from the dead, thou too shall be saved. For with the heart man believeth unto righteousness, and with the mouth he confesseth. And his confession is made unto salvation. So all we have to do is be sincere and find time to go to God. Just, you have to be by yourself. It's just, this is a personal thing. And He will meet you there. And I want to end this by giving you a blessing from Numbers 6:24-26. May the Lord bless you and keep you. May the Lord bless His face to shine upon you and be gracious unto thee. And may the Lord lift up His countenance upon thee and give thee peace. In Jesus' name, I want to say, Jesus truly does love you. Trust Him, and He'll make a believer out of you. This is Lovely Waters. I love you all in Jesus' name. God bless.